Papillon is based on a true story of a man wrongly convicted of murder and sent to life in prison. I say true-ish because the authenticity of Henri Papillon Charriere's autobiography has been debated by researchers. Even Charriere has admitted that it's about 75% true. Nevertheless, the resilience of the human spirit makes for a story as compelling as they come, especially when inspired by real-life events. The story of Papillon, or Papi as he was fondly called, made for a riveting film in 1973 when Steve McQueen played the lead role and Dustin Hoffman played the role of fellow inmate Louise Degas. This new remake has Charlie Hunnam as Papi and Rami Malek as Louise Degas, so right away you can see that they have pretty big shoes to fill. As the story goes, Papi is a safecracker sentenced to life imprisonment after being framed for murder. On his way to jail, Papi befriends Degas, a rich man convicted of fraud. Papi promises to protect the weaker Degas in exchange for money to secure their escape out of their secluded facility. Their plans are thwarted continuously by guards and a warden who merely seeks to break down his inmates rather than rehabilitate them. This game of wits sets the tone for the film. What follows is a harrowing mix of triumphs and setbacks for Papi as he plots his escape amidst escalating challenges. There's also a possible angle to be explored about how prisoners are actually treated, but that's not within the scope of this film since it's told primarily through Papi's eyes. In that sense, Charlie Hunnam is up for the task of documenting the unbelievable plight of a man who's repeatedly pushed to the edge of madness. This is evident especially during solitary confinement, when we spend more time with Papi as he is isolated from human contact. At this point, we get some insight into what made Papi such a hard nut to crack. But it's not quite enough because, oddly, the script is so bland that director Michael Noir ends up downplaying these segments. I believe that this film is entirely hinged on exploring what keeps the human mind intact when it's pushed to the edge. Imagine being defeated over and over again when your life literally depends on getting out. That's what the story is all about, and Noir doesn't get much to play with on that front. So instead, he focuses on the meticulous recreation of Paris in 1933, and the result is great to look at. The cinematography by Hagen Bogdanski returns the favor with some luscious images amidst the dire circumstances of prison life. Sadly, this proves to be an eyewash when the concept of the film hinges on exploring mental tenacity, as I mentioned earlier, and this ended up being a sore point for me. Another element that troubled me was that the foundation of Papi and Degas' friendship felt very rushed. These are two guys who didn't know each other before prison and all of a sudden were meant to just accept that they would sacrifice their sanity for each other. Granted, the chemistry between Hunnam and Malek is brimming with promise, but it never comes to fruition. That also brings me to Rami Malek's performance in this film. The actor feels grossly underutilized and it's almost like you can sense that he has a lot more to give, but we don't get to see it. This is a classic example of what a weak script does for a film by taking the focus away from where the heart of the film lies. It ends up being a slightly frustrating watch with a runtime well over 2 hours. Papillon is occasionally engaging but never fully immerses you into the nuances of a persistent mind. This is a lukewarm remake, which is why it gets an average 3 stars from me. Guys, did you watch the new version of Papillon? Have you watched the 1973 version instead? Which one would you prefer? Let me know in the comments below. And as always, keep watching It's Entertainment, only on Mirror Now, you first.